This is Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us. I'm Rebecca Vargas.
And I'm Don Brennan, along with John Scalzi. And Terrible Tuesday is underway, and we got the Tuesday night fights.
It is, or Terrific Tuesday. Yeah. I was trying to think about it on a positive note. We've
well,
made it through Monday, right?
Yes, but we have.
Yes, but we got the Tuesday campaign tonight, which at times has gotten ugly.
This is true. Primary in New York.
Big voting day. Mm-hmm. Big voting day. This might tell the story for some candidates, I would think, today.
I would think so.
So we'll see how that plays out. We have gorgeous weather again today. Yesterday was beautiful. You know, today will be about the same, a little less wind around. So for boaters and such who are a little concerned about the breezy conditions we've had, probably get a little bit of a break from that, especially this afternoon as we develop a sea breeze. 81 degrees by about 2 o'clock, probably headed up to about 82 for a daytime high. Fair weather clouds, no rain, low relative humidity, another picture perfect day here on the Sun Coast. Back to you.
How it goes out with the weather. Now a little bit of look at traffic, and right now Bradenton is looking pretty good, but in Sarasota, they're on the maybe on the border there, down on 301, there's an accident right there. And can we click on that and see where the action is? But well, it's right there at 301, basically. And as you keep moving down south, everything else is looking good.
All right, well, tapping our news this morning. With traditionally low voter turnout in March, Sarasota City Commissioners had the option of leaving it up to voters to decide if city elections should be moved to November.
ABC7's Rick Adams has that decision.
Very satisfied with it. Very happy about what took place with it, and I think we're moving in the right direction.
Sarasota resident John Soucy is extremely pleased with the city commissioner's decision not to place a referendum on the November ballot. It's a referendum that would have left it up to the voters to decide whether to move city elections from March of odd number years to November of even number years. Matthew Woodall is someone who continues to push for November city election. He's not happy with Monday night's vote.
They do seek to maintain their stranglehold and maintain their sphere of influence at City Hall, and that's just what we saw here today.
Commissioner Suzanne Atwell is the lone commissioner who voted in favor of the ordinance. The other commissioners say they just weren't ready to move ahead with it.
Personally, I felt like there were more questions than answers and that I needed more information.
Dozens of residents on both sides of the issue had a chance to have their voices heard in front of the commissioners Monday night. Kelly Kirshner, a former city commissioner, is all for keeping the city elections exactly the way they are.
If you put this in a general election cycle, it moves to the bottom of the ballot and then it's subject to all of the static of federal elections.
Meanwhile, other residents told city commissioners a November election would dramatically increase voter turnout.
The percentage of voters that actually vote in the city elections in Sarasota is miserably low most of the time.
City Hall here has become a hot spot. Commissioners continue to tackle and take on many important issues impacting a lot of folks. Reporting from downtown Sarasota, I'm Rick Adams, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
Thank you, Rick. Well, new artwork at the Orange and Main roundabout in downtown Sarasota is getting some mixed reviews. The 20-foot-tall stainless steel piece of art was installed Sunday. The nonprofit group Embracing Our Difference worked to install the sculpture, and it was created by Arizona-based sculptor Blessing Hancock. The sculpture symbolizes unity while celebrating diversity and inclusion, which is what Embracing Our Differences and their annual exhibit is all about. The developers of One Palm Avenue fully funded, donated, and have the sculpture installed. Now, some locals are worried that the artwork will be a distraction for drivers, but others like the addition to the traffic circle.
I think if you've never seen it before, you might take your eye off the road and look at it the first time, not the second time. So it could. Yeah. It could. But I think it's pretty.
Well, it's definitely more modern, but in an attractive way.
I think it might slow people down because walking, it was a little dangerous when they first put this particular roundabout in because it's a little on the smaller size, and so people would just fly through. I think it might be an advantage for them to say, oh, look, and slow down and see what's there.
This piece of art was approved by the city engineer for safety and by the commissioners and the public art committee for meeting the city's official criteria.
A Sarasota police officer has resigned after being charged with stalking of a female officer. 34-year-old Gregory Tansebox faces a misdemeanor charge, as the Sarasota Herald-Tribune is reporting that he's accused of stalking a fellow officer who Tansebox dated in 2015. The state attorney's office did confirm that charges have been filed. The police department is not commenting while the investigation is still active, but Tansebox's resignation takes effect next week. More beds will be provided to the Salvation Army as commissioners have approved nearly $128,000 in funding to go towards adding 10 additional beds. It was per the request of Sarasota Police Department's homeless outreach team. The decision comes just days after new census data showed the homeless population had increased on the Sun Coast compared to last year.
Well, Sarasota is the place to look if you're trying to get a teaching job. A record number of teachers retiring this year has the district looking for qualified candidates as far out as the Midwest to fill the spots. ABC 7's Dwayne Lindo has the story.
Open your Revit Up book to page 109.
For McIntosh Middle School English teacher Phyllis Flatt, her students are a priority.
I was one of those teachers that often put my students ahead of my own personal children.
And now that she's been teaching for 30 years, the last 13 at McIntosh, she's had the realization that her tenure is coming to an end.
I never thought I would ever retire.
She is one of more than 150 teachers retiring in Sarasota County. Many of them enrolled in the state's Drop Retirement Program. It allows them to collect retirement benefits while teaching. But they must retire at the end of their drop period, which typically runs 5 years from the time they first enter the program.
So we had a large number of people go in at a certain date. They're all leaving now at the same time.
The school district's director of human resources, Roy Sprinkle, heads recruiting to fill these gaps. He says the district is conducting face-to-face interviews.
So we're doing a lot more online, bringing them in through different marketing schemes and through our website.
District officials also broadening their search, recruiting in the Midwest and college fairs around the state.
So it's always good to get some fresh mindsets from different places, get some energy flowing back through.
Not only bringing in energy, but retaining that energy for years to come.
We're able to do the things we do, like our high average salaries in the state of Florida, because we're supported by the taxpayers in our referendum.
And as for Flatt, she's planning on doing a little recruiting herself.
I'm hoping to steer my daughter even in joining the career. She's volunteered here quite frequently out through high school and her college years. And now that she's a graduate, we're going to see if there might be a place for her here too.
And many of these soon-to-be retired teachers, like Phyllis Flatt, will also come back on a volunteer basis and mentor first-year teachers. Back to you.
New this morning, major moves are in place for next year's Bradenton Area River Regatta. Now, the Bradenton Herald is reporting the city of Palmetto became the first to approve the return of the racing regatta last night. Next year's regatta is scheduled for February 4th of next year, 2017. This will be the third year of the races. This year's regatta was soured with rain and cold weather, and organizers are hoping to improve attendance for next year's event by bringing in more attractions and recruiting more partners and sponsors. Approvals from the city of Bradenton and Manatee County are expected to follow. Also, Sarasota County is looking for volunteers to take part in a seagrass survey. It's a hands-on event where people can learn about seagrass habitat up close. Volunteers will meet up at Ken Thompson Park and spend time in Sarasota Bay counting and identifying seagrass species. The information will be sent to the county's seagrass monitoring program. People who have boats, snorkeling gear, kayaks, or paddleboards can take part in this. The event will be on Saturday, April 30th, starting at 7:30 in the morning, but you must register by April 25th.
Well, it's going to be a little bit louder than usual around Sarasota Bradenton International Airport this week. Boeing is conducting low altitude and warm temperature performance tests on its new 737 MAX aircraft. It will be flying at 1,500 feet between the airport and the Gulf of Mexico. And unlike the old Boeing 737, the new Boeing has a quieter engine. Tests on the plane started yesterday, and if weather permits, the aircrafts will fly out again today and tomorrow. The tests will wrap up on Thursday, where it will then fly to Bolivia for high altitude tests.
I mean, you said it's going to be high noise. I thought maybe the Concorde was coming back.
Just a little bit of noise.
The idea is that it produces a little less noise, right? So that's nice. We always like less noise and under the aircraft.
Yeah, high traffic.
Going on at SRQ.
That's low altitude, though, right?
Yeah, 1,500 feet. Just, yeah.
be kind of fun
Could
to
be a
see
fun,
that.
Yeah, good yeah. sight to see.
I'll be watching out for that today. So will our Ospreys, no doubt.
Oh, yeah,
sure,
that's going to be really close
pattern,
to them.
Right?
Yeah.
They got to hear that all the time as planes landing and taking off overhead.
Look how big Sunny has gotten.
Isn't I know.
That, isn't that something?
In yeah, just a few look at short those days. Feathers. I just can't imagine.
He's hopping around. Look, I think he's got flight fever.
You think so? He's 20 years old now. He went from teenager. He's in his 20s.
In Osprey years,
he's already in his 20s.
I tell you what, it won't be long, I think, before he gives it a shot here. He's got to develop one more set of feathers, I think, before. Okay.
How do you know when you're ready? Because you just jump out of the nest if you're not ready.
I will never be ready. If you're asking me personally,
never
ready. I'm not jumping out of that nest.
Come on, Birdman.
Mama knows best. She'll leave it to her.
It's interesting. Just one day, I guess, the weather's right. Feathers are tickling in just the right way.
And yeah.
You look at the horizon and you make that leap.
Yeah.
And you better know what you're doing.
Yeah. Man, and our cameras will be there to show it all.
Yeah, it'll be fun.
All right. Well, it's not spring cleaning, but Venice City officials are cleaning up in preparation for the relocation of its library. We'll explain.
Shop GoWildHonda.com. Lease a new Civic for $169. A Civic, just $169. Now at GoWildHonda.com. Or visit Wild Honda, Sarasota. It's gotta be wild.
Hey, Vanna, have you heard about the new Wheel of Fortune lottery game?
You bet. It's the ticket for some lucky lottery players to come here to Hollywood.
For a chance to participate in a private, non-broadcast taping of Wheel of Fortune with us.
Play the Florida Lottery game for a chance to win up to $250,000 instantly. And enter to win a VIP trip to Hollywood for a chance to win up to $1 million. Non-winning tickets only.
Play the new Wheel of Fortune game today.
Scratch, spin, and win.
This is a special health alert for seniors suffering with joint pain. If you have Medicare insurance, you may qualify for high-quality support braces at little or no cost.
I'm thrilled with my knee braces.
Now, there is a simple and proven solution for seniors to get out of pain with state-of-the-art support braces.
I barely feel any pain at all.
Braces for your knees and back, as well as your shoulders and ankles, too.
I'm so happy with the quality of these braces.
Call now, and you could qualify for a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost.
I can play ball again and it doesn't hurt.
And because of my Medicare coverage, it costs me next to nothing.
So call now.
And because I have this red, white, and blue Medicare card, my braces have cost me just about nothing.
It's true. You may get a knee, back, shoulder, and ankle brace at little or no cost.
They qualified me for two knee braces and a back brace.
If you have knee or back pain, give them a call. They can help.
1-800-476-8967. 1-800-476-8967.
So many possibilities worth exploring. Manasota Flooring.
And for a limited time, Manasota Flooring is offering you unbelievable pricing on tile and laminate. Porcelain tile, only $1.59. Ceramic tile, 99 cents. And 16 by 16 tile, $1.19. Laminate flooring is only 99 cents. But these prices won't last. Don't miss out on these great deals. Hurry into Manasota Flooring today.
Shop GoWildHonda.com. Lease a new Accord for $189, just $189, or 0.9% APR. Now at GoWildHonda.com or visit Wild Honda, Sarasota. It's gotta be wild.
Now, the official Suncoast weather with ABC 7 meteorologist John Scalzi.
Current air conditions outside coming in at 61 degrees with a dew point of 55. Again, a very pleasant dry air mass over the state of Florida, making us feel very comfortable out there. Winds are now east, northeast at about 7. That little northerly component helping to draw down that drier air. Clear skies out there and a beautiful moonlit morning. We have across the region temperatures that are generally holding in the upper 50s in inland areas and closer to the 60 mark as you get nearer the coast. We have 63 degrees at Longboat Key, 61 as I mentioned, Sarasota, 62 in Venice and in Inglewood, 59 Bradenton Parish, 60 Longboat Key, and then you get into the 50s, 58 degree Mayaca City, 58 Wachula, 59 Arcadia, 56 in Punta Gorda. Across the region, everything's quiet in terms of any kind of rainfall. Again, it'll be a rain-free day. one more time. We'll have skies that'll be fairly sunny by afternoon with just a few fair weather clouds dotting the horizon. Not much in the way of a rainfall chance anywhere across the Florida Peninsula today, or the Mid-Atlantic, or the Deep South, or on up into down east Maine, where some showers are now exiting the Boston region. We'll watch for showers again, a big problem in parts of the plains. I think Texas will once again see the possibility of some tornadic activity today, especially in the southern tip of the state and in the most western sections of the state. But basically, it's going to be a rain event one more time, and that's going to again exacerbate the flooding problems that they have had there over the last several days. Cloud cover is going to have a difficult time making it into our region with that high pressure ridge sitting over us, the cloud cover from the storms back in Texas. So any cloud cover we get, I think, will probably be of the locally grown variety and most likely occur mostly in the afternoon with that sea breeze front building. High pressure, again, the dominant weather feature for us, directs our winds out of a generally easterly direction, northeast, east, maybe a little bit of southeast direction, but in general, a dry easterly flow continues for today and for the next several days. The frontal boundary remains kind of locked back to the west. Don't see much of a chance of that moving too terribly much over the next several days. It really will take another push of cooler air coming down from Canada to finally get this system to move after the high kind of moves a little bit further out into the Atlantic and allows room for that frontal boundary to advance. When it does advance, it'll bring us a rain chance on Friday, but even then, the front will be in a weakening state by the time it gets to the state of Florida, so don't expect much from it. Mostly, the picture that you see here is the picture we're going to be showing for the next several days, looks like. Forecast for today, mostly sunny skies, less wind around. I think a little less wind today than we saw yesterday as high pressure continues to build. And still dry across the region. Rainfall future cast shows a little bit of cloud cover, maybe a spot or two of rain over on the other coast because of that easterly flow there, but not much of a rain chance. Right straight through Wednesday over our area. We stay dry. Forecast does show a bullseye for severe weather possibilities in the western section of the state of Texas. Otherwise, thunderstorms will continue across most of the central parts of the United States. Beach and boating forecast calls for that east wind shifting west with a sea breeze in the afternoon at about 10 knots. We'll watch the wind kind of surge just a little bit as we head into the evening hours and that sea breeze collapses. 2-foot seas, a light to moderate chop. And as far as the tidal information goes, we've got a couple. We're at a low tide now. High tide comes at 12:02, another low tide at 7:03, and the official Suncoast forecast calls for nice weather, right straight. Even Friday, I don't think we'll see much in the way of rainfall. And then Saturday and Sunday look to be great. Back to you.
Thank you, John. As far as your commute right now at 518, taking a look at the traffic in Manatee County. We don't have much of it so far this morning, which is good to see. The Palmetto bridges look good, so does State Road 70 in the interstate. Downtown Bradenton moving along well there on 41 and 301 into Sarasota. Any accidents that were being reported on 301 are now cleared up. Everything is moving along great. The arteries at 75 look good. Just a little bit of a slowdown in the downtown area at some intersections, but that's just typical morning buildup. Other than that, as we head further into South County, I'm not seeing any issues. The interstate looks good. Let's zoom out there. Yep, and South County is looking good.
All right. Thank you, Rebecca. Now, the next step for the Venice Public Library is in the process of being taken.
Yeah, last week, staff members began going through all the books in the old library, cataloging them, cleaning them before they get them moved to the temporary location. ABC 7's Christopher Brantley has the details.
Librarians accustomed to using a tender touch on books are now going through them one by one by the thousands, donned with gloves and respirators.
We've worked with our health department and our risk and safety staff to be sure that the staff that are in the building are following the precautions that they outlined for us.
In this mostly empty library, it's not just the books being evaluated and cleaned. It's also the furniture, even the computers.
I've never seen any dampness in them, and that is where you get first a problem with mildew, etc.
Julia Evans is a library regular who is not convinced the county did enough to keep this library open.
I don't think they investigated it quite enough. When you have a flat roof building, there are potential problems there that maybe could have been corrected.
As it has been, the feeling was echoed by people we spoke to on Monday.
Love to see them fix the old library. That was a fabulous place. You know, I really miss that.
As the books are sorted, 18,000 will be going to the temporary library at the Hamilton Condominium Building when construction is done on it. The remainder of the books will be sent to other libraries in the county or thrown away, but they will all, at first, be cleaned.
Well, I think it's extra added expense that probably is not necessary. I think they were pretty clean.
But the county says it is necessary to clean the books that have been in the library to ensure the mold issue that closed this library does not come back.
In Venice, Christopher Brantley, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
And 100 new jobs are coming to the Suncoast, all thanks to Total Quality Logistics, or TQL. They'll be expanding in Sarasota, and TQL will set up shop in the BB&T building on 2nd Street. It's scheduled to open in June and plans to bring those 100 jobs by 2020. TQL is one of the biggest freight brokerage firms in the country. Oh, more jobs coming to the Suncoast.
Always good to see. Well, still ahead on Good Morning Suncoast, the candidates for president are gearing up for another primary. Who's still leading in the polls and who's not giving up?
But first, who could forget this cute little phase, how the United States Postal Service is remembering a legendary child star? I'll tell you more when we come back.
They're coming from Tampa, Fort Myers, even Orlando. They're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, because Sarasota Ford guarantees you our lowest price on every new Ford every day. Save on America's best-selling truck, 39 years running, the Ford F-150. Fusions, Escapes, over 800 vehicles on-site or online, all on sale. Buy with 0% for 60 months. And now, get up to 2,000 trade assistance. That's why they're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, where 41 meets 301. SarasotaFord.com.
Attention. This is an important message for anyone who had an IVC filter placed to prevent blood clots from traveling to their heart or lungs. Did your IVC filter move, break, or cause organ damage? The FDA warns that IVC filters may cause serious complications, such as heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, even death. If you or a loved one suffered serious complications, call IVC Filter Helpline now. You may be entitled to compensation. IVC filters are designed to prevent blood clots. If your IVC filter moved or broke, and you suffered heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, or if a loved one died as a result, call IVC Filter Helpline today. Our network of experienced attorneys is ready to fight for you. You'll pay nothing unless there's a recovery in your favor. Call today for a free confidential consultation. Don't fight this alone. Call IVC Filter Helpline now.
Please call 800-897-6764. That is 800-897-6764.
At Sunset Subaru, it's all about getting more for your money. More years, more miles, more 2016 IIHS Top Safety Pick Plus winners than any other brand. And right now, you can lease the most award-winning small SUV on the planet, a new 2016 Subaru Forester, for just $229 a month, complimentary maintenance included, at the new redesigned Sunset Subaru dealership in Sarasota. Get more for your money. Go to Sunset Subaru in Sarasota.
Welcome back. It's 5:23. The wild ride on Wall Street is continuing as the Dow is now at a level it hasn't hit in nearly 9 months.
Now we can have Shirley Temple in our mailboxes. ABC's Ryan Smith and Diane Macedo have this morning's business headlines.
Good morning. Tapping America's money, the boost for your 401k.
Wall Street opens this morning closer to an all-time high. The Dow gained 106 points to close just above 18,000, the highest level since July.
Stock markets around the world are also higher this morning.
Now, even though gas prices have been rising recently, experts say this summer they'll be the lowest in a dozen years. The Energy Department expects an average of $2.04.
This morning it's $2.11. Prices should start falling soon. And the newest stamp in your post office honors one of the biggest movie stars of the 1930s, Shirley Temple.
That's right. The child star was the biggest box office draw for four straight years, bigger than Clark Gable or Bing Crosby. The stamp design shows her at age 7 in the movie Curly Top.
Love those movies.
And that's America's Money.
Have a great day, everyone.
America's Money, brought to you by Angie's List.
At Angie's List, we guarantee a fair price, quality service, and that horrible smells are really good at hiding.
Oh, boy.
There it is.
So when you need a house cleaner or an exterminator, we can help you get the job done right, guaranteed. Get started today at Angie's List, because your home is where our heart is.
I take pictures of sunrises, but with my back pain, I couldn't sleep and get up in time. Then I found Aleve PM.
Aleve PM is the only one to combine a safe sleep aid plus the 12-hour pain-relieving strength of Aleve.
I'm back.
Aleve PM for a better AM.
Okay, you sure it won't ruin it?
Trust me, Silk Unsweetened Almond Milk tastes great, and it has less than half the calories of skim milk.
Mmm.
Contain your enthusiasm.
Hey.
With delicious taste and less than half the calories, Silk helps you bloom.
Tonight on ABC 7 News at 7.
You only got Trump. That's all you have. You have to have it. Okay? You will be so happy.
I will stand up and fight for you through this campaign and into the White House.
Clinton and Trump lead in New York, but could there be an upset in the Empire State? We get the local take with our panel. I'm Alan Cohn. We'll have that story plus our roundtable discussion.
Tonight on ABC 7 News at 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you. Gas prices are on the rise again, so before you fill up, go to mysuncoast.com for a list of the Suncoast's cheapest gas. ABC 7's Pump Patrol. Just another way we're here for you.
The spring clearance event is going on now, and the prices are hotter than ever at Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota. Drive America's hottest SUV, a new Jeep Cherokee, for just $19,999. Lease a new Compass for just $199 a month with no tricks, no gimmicks. Just $799 total due at signing. Or buy a new 2000 Jeep Patriot for just $15,799. Better prices, bigger selection. Go to Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names. Really? They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
Call right now to get your free Senior Care Compass ebook. Find out about the 5 best kept secrets on financing senior care and assisted living.
Call now, 800-290-0352. 800-290-0352.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. For a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today. Sleep on it tonight.
Sunset Fiat is Italian style. Sunset Fiat is fashion forward. Come see the all-new Fiat collection at Sunset Fiat with new 2015 Fiat 500s priced from $12,999. Sunset Fiat is cool and sexy with freedom to move and room to evolve. Visit Sunset Fiat in Sarasota or shop online at fiatusaofsarasota.com.
Coming up on Good Morning Suncoast, raging waters put the Lone Star State under a state of emergency.
And Florida is standing its ground on banning gay marriage, but the fight could be costly for taxpayers.
And world-class athletes are crowding the waters of local park in hopes of making the Olympic team.
Live from the ABC 7 studios, this is Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you.
Welcome back. I'm Rebecca Vargas.
Hello, John Scalzi. I'm Don Brennan. And geez, the Olympic trials and Paralympic trials got some beautiful weather yesterday. Be out there rolling on Benderson Park.
They dialed up
the
weather.
Though.
Yeah, it is a little windy for them.
For us to watch, it was nice.
Yes, that's true. That's very true.
We stay cool, but they're out there trying to push against the wind.
Yeah, but today will be lighter wind. So I wonder if that'll affect the times of any of the athletes.
Yesterday, I think they were practicing. So if this is competition time, then it might be even more in their favor.
Perfect. Great day to get out there and watch and root.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Should be nice weather. We're looking for daytime highs to top out like yesterday, coming in the low 80s. Plenty of sunshine around, no rain in the forecast. Drier than average air sitting over the state of Florida will keep the rainfall away for the next several days, in fact. We will see the winds kind of lighten up just a little bit today. They may surge late in the day, but I think for most of the afternoon, you'll notice them being lighter than they have been over the last couple of days. Back to you.
Thank you, John. Taking a look at traffic this morning at 5:30. Everything in Bradenton and Manatee County as a whole seems to be moving along without a problem. Not a lot of volume on the roadways this time in the morning, but I'm sure it'll be picking up, and we'll keep you posted as to what's going on. Moving down into Sarasota County, there is some hot spots on 301 as you head north and south between State Road 70 and State Road 64 coming into Sarasota, but everything else seems to be moving along without any issue.
Topping our news this half hour, dramatic images are now coming out of Houston, Texas, where flooding has killed at least five and forced thousands out of their homes.
And the governor now has declared a state of emergency in 9 counties. Raging floodwaters sweep through low-lying parts of Houston, trapping drivers in their cars and thousands in their homes.
Oh, you all right?
These residents escape with their children on anything that floats, even a refrigerator. Across the city, hundreds of high water rescues, including this attempt to lead a horse to higher ground. The downpour, nearly 20 inches, was deadly for drivers. At least 5 bodies were found in submerged vehicles. A plea from the governor.
Please remember the easy phrase, turn around, don't drown. Stay out of the rising water.
The danger captured during this live news report on our ABC station KTRK.
What can I do? Swim.
The driver escaping just seconds before his car goes under. The damage spreads for miles through neighborhoods after neighborhood, leaving many disheartened.
We're still recovering from last year. Now we're back to square one again.
And most, like Deborah Wright, stranded on her second floor balcony until this unusual rescue on a monster truck, are grateful for their communities coming together.
It's just been an adventurous day.
All right, more rain is expected in the area over the next few days, but the downpour won't be as heavy, thankfully. Flood warnings and watches will remain in effect in southern Texas most of the day.
The latest on series of earthquakes in Japan, officials say the death toll there is likely to rise. Today, crews are digging through a mountainous area of southern Japan where twin earthquakes triggered landslides over the weekend. More bodies have been found, bringing the death toll from 43 to at least 45, but that number is likely to rise. About 100,000 evacuees have been sleeping outdoors as aftershocks continue there. Meanwhile, rescuers in Ecuador are racing against time to find survivors of a powerful 7.8 magnitude quake over the weekend there. The death toll has risen to over 400. At least one of those killed was an American, and dozens of people are still missing. Yesterday, a group of rescuers freed 8 people trapped for more than 32 hours in the rubble of a shopping center. And officials are calling this the deadliest earthquake to hit Ecuador in almost 30 years.
On the campaign trail, it's primary day in New York and the next crucial battle in the race for the White House. A big win in New York is crucial for Donald Trump. He's reminding his New York supporters to get out and vote. And Ted Cruz, well, he swept up more delegates this weekend and is already setting his eyes on November.
Because if I'm the nominee, we win the general election. We're beating Hillary in the key swing states. We're beating Hillary with independents. We're beating Hillary with young people.
On the Democrat side, Bernie Sanders needs to win 80% of the remaining delegates to clinch the nomination. Hillary Clinton may be ahead, but the former New York senator says she's not taking any place or person for granted, making 8 campaign stops in her home state. The other candidates have already moved on to other states. Trump and Clinton are the only 2 staying in the state tonight to watch the results come in.
It's one of the most hotly debated topics in the presidential campaign, and now it's at the forefront again. The U.S. Supreme Court is taking up one of its biggest cases this term, challenging President Obama's immigration plan. The case was brought to the court by a group of 26 states, including Florida, challenging President Obama's executive order. The order would spare nearly 4 million unauthorized immigrants who are parents of citizens from deportation and would allow them to work, all in an effort to keep families together. But those programs have been on hold since February of 2015 after a lower court struck down the president's executive order, saying he overstepped his authority and ignored Congress.
And it's pretty clear that Congress passes laws and the president simply enforces them.
The alternative is that the parents are constantly in danger of being placed in proceedings and removed from the country with all of the ensuing disruption to families.
A decision is expected by this summer.
The state of Florida's fight to keep a ban on gay marriage intact is going to wind up costing taxpayers. A U.S. district judge has ordered the state to pay the fees of attorneys who filed federal lawsuits challenging the state's voter-approved ban. He ruled that the attorneys were eligible for payment because they were successful in the lawsuit. The U.S. Supreme Court legalized gay marriage across the country last June. The total amount of fees has yet to be determined.
The body of a missing Florida priest has been found all the way in Georgia. The body of 71-year-old Father Rene Robert was discovered yesterday by police in Waynesboro, Georgia. Robert had been missing since last week, and police had arrested 28-year-old Stephen James Murray on Thursday after he was found driving the St. Augustine's-based priest's car in South Carolina. Murray will be charged with first-degree murder and kidnapping. A motive for the crime is unclear at this point. And a follow-up now to a man accused of tossing his daughter over a Tampa Bay area bridge. A judge has decided to postpone the hearing for John Johnchuk. He's charged in the death of his 5-year-old daughter, Phoebe. In 2015, he dropped his 5-year-old daughter off of a bridge near the Sunshine Skyway Bridge, and yesterday's hearing is scheduled for this Monday. Johnchuk was ruled by doctors to be incompetent to stand trial in February for the third time and has been in a state mental hospital. If Johnchuk is found guilty, prosecutors say that they plan to seek the death penalty.
It was a sweeping finish for the Boston Marathon yesterday. More than 27,000 runners participated, and among the runners were two survivors of the bombings in 2013. Both of them lost their legs in the attacks, but were quite optimistic yesterday, saying peace and love and goodness will always prevail. And this was the 127th year of the run. And this Saturday, April 23rd, is the first annual Navy SEAL golf and dinner benefit for one of those who has served our country. Brian Bill was a Navy SEAL who died while on duty in Afghanistan. This weekend's benefit dinner was created in his memory by his dad, Scott Bill. The golf and dinner is at the Ritz-Carlton Members Club, and you can log on to the BrianBillFoundation.org website for more information on how to get tickets and get involved. And the proceeds will benefit families who have lost servicemen. And he's from Stamford, Connecticut, Brian Bill. So
awesome.
Yes, another Connecticutian.
Yes.
See, we serve.
Yeah,
Meanwhile, we have our own race going on here on the Sun Coast.
Yes, we do. There is lots of rowing going on this week at Nathan Benderson Park for the 2016 U.S. Olympic and Paralympic team trials, and there are 9 competitions taking place over the course of the week. The winners will be nominated to the U.S. Olympic team. Gevi Stone is among the world-class athletes on the Suncoast participating. Stone won at this event in 2012 and went on to represent the U.S. in the Olympics.
The stakes are as high as they will ever get in the sport of rowing. The Olympic Games is the pinnacle of these athletes' careers.
It's amazing to be out at Benderson because they've put so much into turning this into a world-class course. The facilities are amazing. The lanes are amazing. Everything is top-notch here.
The practices were held yesterday. An actual competition gets underway this morning at 8.
And it's being called the first field of its kind in the city of Sarasota and Sarasota County. A groundbreaking ceremony scheduled for this morning for the artificial turf field project. The current field space at Robert L. Taylor Community Complex will be transformed into an artificial multi-purpose turf field with new lighting, fencing, irrigation, parking, and concession stands. City officials are calling it a highly anticipated project. The groundbreaking takes place at the Taylor Community Complex at 9 this morning. So, yeah, a lot of people going with field turf now because it's much better for the kids and it's less money for maintenance and upkeep.
That's true. Yeah, they
and,
upkeep.
And it's good for the kids to play on, too. My son plays on artificial field turf. You don't have to worry about the dirt and the grass and mowing the grass and lining the field. It's pain and rent off.
So you don't have to get, mom doesn't have to worry about getting all those stains out of their clothes.
Well, dads do laundry, too, you know.
That's true. I'm sorry.
See, equal rights.
Parents don't have to worry about getting the stains out of their kids' clothes anymore. There you go.
Don't have to fertilize it. Don't have to mow it.
Yep. I hope that all works out.
We have some beautiful weather heading down the road. If you want to get out and about and enjoy a park, why the weather will cooperate nicely. We'll talk about that in a second.
All right. Thanks, John. And parents need to get their kids to eat more fruits and vegetables, but it's a difficult task. And how can you make sure the produce you're feeding them is healthy? We'll have some tips coming up.
And working odd hours can be a drag for anyone, but it especially takes a toll on women. That story next in Health News.
Express yourself in your new wild Lexus. Lease a new 2016 Lexus ES350 for only $299 or enjoy 0.9% APR. Just $299 exclusively at Wild Lexus of Sarasota on Clark Road.
It's a mortgage sale for a limited time at Trusco Bank. No application fee. Stop in any branch today. Save even more with low closing costs. See why your neighbors choose Trusco Bank. Visit TruscoBank.com for details.
Your hometown bank, Trusco.
Equal housing lender.
U.S. Med has great news for anyone living with diabetes.
If you have Medicare, private insurance, or prescription drug coverage, U.S. Med will ship a new glucose meter right to your home.
And shipping is free.
My new meter uses only a speck of blood, so it's less painful than my previous meter.
If you have Medicare, private insurance, or prescription drug coverage, you're covered with U.S. Med. We're welcoming new patients, even if your current provider can't supply you anymore.
I don't even have to test on my fingers anymore. I can test on my hand or forearms, and it's more accurate than my old meter.
So call US Med today, and you'll have a choice of two great meters.
One that actually speaks your results, or a meter so small it fits in the bottle of strips.
Act now, and US Med will include a free prescription discount card. We'll also send you a free diabetes cookbook. This is your opportunity.
So call US Med today.
You'll be glad you did.
They're coming from Tampa, Fort Myers, even Orlando. They're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford because Sarasota Ford guarantees you our lowest price on every new Ford every day. Save on America's best-selling truck 39 years running, the Ford F-150. Fusions, Escapes, over 800 vehicles on-site or online, all on sale. Buy with 0% for 60 months. And now, get up to 2,000 trade assistance. That's why they're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, where 41 meets 301. SarasotaFord.com.
The home at 19 Walker Court. The agent. The rolling of sleeves. The look over. The look under. The application of dirt under fingernails. Turning over every rock. Turning over every chimney. Checking the nooks, checking the crannies, checking the walls. The floors, the gutters, the doors. Finding the flaw. Calling the specialist. Fixing it, cleaning it, prepping it, painting it, listing it, showing it, selling it. The sign of a REMAX agent.
Need more space in your place? The More Space Place can help. With Murphy beds that disappear to reveal a home office, living room, or den. Custom closets with designated areas for your shoes, bags, wardrobe, and accessories. Custom-built entertainment centers, garage storage systems, and more. The More Space Place has three showrooms next to Sonny's on US 41 South in Sarasota, on Lakewood Ranch Boulevard just south of State Route 64 in Bradenton, and on Tamiami Trail next to Panera Bread in Port Charlotte. Put more space in your place at the More Space Place.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free. AndServices.com. A-N-D, services.com.
Express yourself in your new wild Lexus. Lease a new 2016 Lexus IS200T for only $299. Or enjoy 0.9% APR. Just $299. Exclusively at Wild Lexus of Sarasota on Clark Road.
Now, the official Suncoast weather with ABC7 meteorologist John Scalzi.
Current air temperature outside, a very pleasant 61 degrees. Dew point comes in at 55. We have an east-northeast wind coming in at about 7 right now, so the winds will probably be a little bit lighter this afternoon as high pressure continues to build in and progress a little further to the south. Clear skies out there right now. moonlit, beautiful, almost a full moon. Full moon comes this weekend. We have across the region temperatures generally in the 50s in inland areas, right along the coastline, generally in the low 60s. 63 degrees Longboat Key, 63 in Venice, 62 in Inglewood, 59 in Bradenton Parish, Lakewood Ranch at 60, 59 Wachula, Myakka, Arcadia, 56 in Punta Gorda, and Northport comes in at 60 degrees. So across the region, well, quiet. Nothing showing up on radar, nor do we really anticipate much today. The air, again, way too dry to support any kind of organized showers across the state of Florida. If we see anything at all, it'll most likely be over on the other coast where we'll maybe pick up a shower or two due to that wind flow that'll generally be easterly today. The center part of the country, again, today, unsettled with a lot of rain showers possible throughout areas that stretch from the Delmarva back to western Texas and all the way up to the northern tier. Most likely scattered showers and thunderstorms the further north you go, but I think around the Texas area there is a potential for some severe weather, perhaps even a tornadic activity, western parts of the state and southern parts most particularly. Otherwise, it'll most likely just be another day with some periods of heavy rain in Texas, which is exactly what they don't need. Some of the blow-off cloud cover seen in the Gulf waters, this is going to have a hard time making it into our area. I think the cloud cover that we get will be most apparent along the sea breeze front a little bit later in the afternoon in inland areas, just like it was yesterday. High pressure remains the dominant weather feature for us. Circulation around that high pressure ridge bringing us that easterly wind flow, at times northeasterly as it is currently, at times even southeasterly. But in general, the easterly flow continues. The front stays locked back to the west. High pressure stays with us for the next several days, and nothing really changes as long as that high pressure sits right where it's sitting. Everything's kind of locked in place. But as that high eventually toward the end of the week moves out into the Atlantic and a surge of cooler air drops down from Canada, it will allow that front to finally pick up some steam and approach the Florida Peninsula, bringing us a chance of rainfall then, although the front will be weakening as it gets closer to the state. Mostly sunny skies, less wind, still dry. Those are your weather highlights for today, and the RPM computer model bears it out. Hardly a chance of rain across the entire peninsula with maybe a scattered shower over on the other coast. Gulf waters looks fine. Should be a nice day for boating. We have generally the best chance of some stronger storms in the western parts of Texas. If today you're flying to Houston or Dallas, the weather will probably be improved over what you saw yesterday. Forecast looks pretty decent for boating. East wind shifting west with sea breeze in the afternoon, surging as that sea breeze collapses at night, light to moderate chop with 2-foot seas. And the forecast looks nice for the next several days. Lots of sunshine, little rain chance, a slight chance of rain on Friday, and then everything clears out for the weekend. Back to you.
Thanks, John. Taking a look at your commute at 547 right now in Manatee County. It looks good. No major problems on the interstate or the Palmetto bridges. Everything is moving along well. 301 starting to pick up in volume, but 41 is nice and clear. State Road 70 still looks good at this point in the morning. As for Sarasota, I'm not seeing any major slowdowns. A little bit of a volume pickup around those major intersections along 41 as you head down in the downtown area. But so far, everything looks great on the interstate. No slowdowns in South County either or any accidents to report. Well, in health news this morning, a new study is showing that acid reflux drugs may dramatically increase the risk of kidney disease and kidney failure.
Yeah, so you don't get esophageal cancer, but you get kidney problems. Drugs like Prilosec and Nexium are called proton pump inhibitors, or PPI, and they're some of the most prescribed medications in the world. Patients who took PPIs had a 96% increased risk of developing kidney failure and a 28% increased risk of chronic kidney disease compared to the patients who took another treatment called histamine.
Ladies, beauty rest may be easier said than done, and according to new research, women might suffer more from a disrupted sleep cycle than men do. Researchers in the United Kingdom tested 16 men and 18 women on a 28-hour day. Results found that women were more tired, especially in the early morning hours. Results also showed that they felt sleepier and it was harder for them to think and complete tasks. But more research will be needed to further test out these differences. They always say that women need a little bit more sleep.
How do you feel about that? Now, five a day fruits and vegetables are a vital part of a child's healthy diet, but make sure that produce is safe to eat. It all starts with how we wash them. Doctors say fruits and veggies should be scrubbed using either safe tap water or distilled water. Anything you're not going to peel the skin off of, like berries, should be washed vigorously under cold water. You can use a scrub brush, but make sure it's not the same one you use to clean the dishes. Ooh, that's a little skanky. Now, when it comes to cleaning some fruits and veggies, it might require a little more work depending on their composition.
Fruits and veggies, they're going to have a lot of crevices, though. You might want to soak in the water for a little bit longer. So things like lettuce, broccoli, cauliflower, things that are hard to get into, I would say soak that in cold water for at least 2 to 3 minutes and then really rinse it off and scrub it with your hands.
As far as produce that is advertised as pre-washed, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration deems them safe to be eaten as is. But if you come across something that just doesn't look or smell right, when in doubt, throw it out.
Well, the so-called superfoods have become all the rage in health, but sometimes you might get sick of a certain type of food or you just might not like the taste at all. If that's the case, there are plenty of alternatives to choose from. For example, cabbage is a great choice if you're looking for something similar to cauliflower. Both vegetables are known to boost immune systems, act as natural detoxifiers, and guard against cancer and heart disease. Go with cranberries if you want an alternative to goji berries. And one study published in the Journal of Nutrition found that cranberries have a type of antioxidant that boosts cell immune response to the cold and to the flu. Yep, get those superfoods in your system.
Now, I must say, I don't know of a lot of people who are looking for alternatives to cauliflower. You might like cauliflower, but you don't say, well, I'm not going to have cauliflower today. What would be something similar? Or goji berries?
That's why we have it for you. That's why we tell you, so you know.
Like, who eats goji berries and says, I'm tired of goji berries today. Let's have some cranberries.
Stay with
us. We'll be right back.
It's Ram Truck Month, and that means big savings on some of America's best vehicles at Sunset Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, Ram in Sarasota. Get America's best value, a new Grand Caravan for just $18,999, or a new Dodge Journey for just $17,999. Stop by today to shop the area's biggest selection of Ram trucks and save up to $8,000 on your new Ram. Better prices, bigger selection. Go to Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota.
Attention, this is an important message for anyone who had an IVC filter placed to prevent blood clots from traveling to their heart or lungs. Did your IVC filter move, break, or cause organ damage? The FDA warns that IVC filters may cause serious complications, such as heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, even death. If you or a loved one suffered serious complications, call IVC Filter Helpline now. You may be entitled to compensation. IVC filters are designed to prevent blood clots. If your IVC filter moved or broke, and you suffered heart or lung damage, internal bleeding, or if a loved one died as a result, call IVC Filter Helpline today. Our network of experienced attorneys is ready to fight for you. You'll pay nothing unless there's a recovery in your favor. Call today for a free confidential consultation. Don't fight this alone. Call IVC Filter Helpline now.
Please call 800-897-6764. That is 800-897-6764.
The kitchen is where life happens. Minnesota Flooring now offers a wide variety of beautiful quality craft-made cabinetry to make sure the heart of your home reflects your style. Visit us today at our new kitchen and bath cabinetry locations.
Pomero Shop Furniture. After 66 years in Sarasota, we're still the leader in hard-to-find and custom-made furniture. We have literally thousands of fabrics and patterns to choose from, and our free in-home design consultation will help you create rooms in your home specific to your unique style. Our inventory changes daily, so come in today to see what's new. Plus, anything in our showroom can be part of your home the very next day. Pomero Shop Furniture, now with 3 locations.
It's a mortgage sale. For a limited time at Trustco Bank, no application fee. Stop in any branch today. Save even more with low closing costs. See why your neighbors choose Trustco Bank. Visit TrustcoBank.com for details.
Your hometown bank, Trustco.
Equal housing lender.
Sunset Fiat is Italian style. Sunset Fiat is fashion forward. Come see the all-new Fiat collection at Sunset Fiat with new 2015 Fiat 500s priced from $12,999. Sunset Fiat is cool and sexy with freedom to move and room to evolve. Visit Sunset Fiat in Sarasota or shop online at fiatusaofsarasota.com.
It is 5:54, and here's what's coming up in our 6 o'clock hour. During a meeting last night, the city of Sarasota makes a decision as to whether or not they will move city elections from March to November. And Boeing is conducting low-altitude testing on its new 737 MAX aircraft at Sarasota Bradenton International, so you might hear a little bit more noise in that area. And dozens of new jobs are coming to the Suncoast after a nationally known freight brokerage firm announces that it's moving its operations to Sarasota. More jobs on the way.
And finally this morning, a 100-year-old woman went on an unforgettable journey. Thousands of feet in the air, and it happened yesterday as Marie Smith and eight other seniors had the opportunity to fly in a World War II training plane. It's all part of a nonprofit catering to senior flights in California. Smith is just shy of her 102nd birthday, making her the second oldest person that's ever been flown. Smith says she's not dead yet, so why not still enjoy life? I'm not dead, so why not live? Well, you still can, right?
Why
that
not?
That is a great...
That is incredible. Look at them. They're so sweet.
You know what? You got to risk losing to win. That's the bottom line.
Right.
And she's going up, taking a chance. And
going up in a World War II plane. Wow. Just how much has happened for them in their lives
to see
World War II, you know, even before then, until now.
Cool.
Can you imagine?
You think, if you're
cognizant, that's really neat.
Of things when you're 5 years old, so from the time she was five
yeah.
to now, you know, wow.
How
she's
probably older than the plane.
Yeah, it's all.
Yeah.
Sure.
And then how technology's changed. We're going from those planes to now hoverboards.
I wonder if she'd take a ride on the hoverboard. She seems pretty adventurous.
Yeah, you never know.
That's really awesome.
All
good for her.
You
good
can
for
do
her.
In 102 years.
Right?
All right, it is 5:56. We'll be right back.